No gentle way to do this. I have to cut it and form a new loop. I'm just guessing how much to take off. About 15% of it. Because it's spring material, it's really not happy about being bent into new shapes. That's a small one. It's just a simple matter of reinstalling it. That should be easy to do. Which end first? Wow. Easy to do? No. I don't think this is easy to do at all. So I hook on one end, that's fairly easy. It's getting the other end on. Which one's going to be easier? I think I'm better off putting on this end. I think it grips a little bit. That's what it looks like to me. Easy about getting that on. Okay, so I'm going to try to put it on this way. I'll worry about swinging it later. Can I actually get it on there? Looks like it. It looks like I did it. Oh. Nope, false impression. Let me take a closer look with this camera here. Oh, it's on there. Now I gotta swing it up under, without knowing what's under there. And hopefully it won't come off. Somehow I gotta... I can't even see it. Wait a minute. Really hard to get a look in there. Lost as to where it is here. Oh, it's appearing in a little hole there. It is. Now what am I going to do with it? I got to stretch it all the way to here. Which I really got to try to hook it like this. This tool won't hold it. If I hook it, it won't hold it. I have to hook it with this one. I got it. Now what am I doing with it? Now I gotta get it to go under here. So I'll get a grip of it, the spring back a few turns here. The tool I'm using in my right hand, if I just rotate it in the wrong way, it'll just drop it. Oh boy. Okay, not so sure you really want to watch this struggle. I think it's going to get very painful. I think that's where I'm heading here. Painful experience. Let me just adjust the focus again on this other camera. Find out it's actually easier the other way. You know, I think it's nearly impossible in either direction. I think that's the story. That's all I'm doing is I don't want to, whoops, stretch the spring out of shape. Use one tool to get it onto the other tool. It is in. Ha! How do you like that? Success. Wasn't so bad. Wonder if it helped. It's only real success if it helps. Let's give it a go. Okay, what are the odds that this fixed it? Oh, I don't know. Well, I'm going to give it 50-50 odds on this. Make sure the idler's out of the way when you drop the platter on. Should be pretty obvious as soon as I push this over to reject. It should come back to the on position. Shouldn't sit in the reject position. Okay, let's bring out our ever so wonderful Beastie Boys record. Here we go. Okay. Push this over and it should come right back. Stuck. Stuck even worse. Sitting on. Not bad. Watch it go off. Come on. Oh, it almost made it. Just Just that little hair there. What was that? It's much better. Okay, this time it should not come over. It should just go up and down. That didn't quite turn off again. Okay, so with just that last bit of this motion, it's still the spring, if that's what's responsible for making that happen. Still not quite working. I'm just taking the platter off so it doesn't fall off when I get this tipped up. It takes a little weight out of the picture too. The chances that I haven't diagnosed it right. I think we saw a pretty good improvement there. You got the right idea. Now, the last, let's see, I'll put the switch on. That's on. To turn it off, it's got to fight something right here. What is it fighting? This mechanism is the spring is really pulling on it. And it should be coming back though. Right now, it should just fall back to here. That's a tough part right there too. And I'm certain if I tighten this spring up, for all I know is I'm creating new tensions in the mechanism that, you know. What's going on with the shape of this? Let's take a closer look at that. There's a divot. And the shape of that piece right there. Is it that? Something else catching. Difficult in it right there. Let me pull this plate forward down here. Friction point right in there. lift it off it. Right there, it's lifting off. Right in here. It's happening somewhere where we can't really see it. Shoot some lubricant right up in here. It's an act of desperation. Still a very difficult spot to get over. You can even see in the push rod, which is mostly out of the camera, that it's straining. It's another spring down here, but that's not. Frustrations abound. Good question right now would be, can you always make these things work? Probably about 80% successful with record players like this at getting them to work perfectly, or close enough to perfect to be, you know, fully functional. Maybe not as smooth as you might like, but. Once again, let's give it a try here.